cities, India too. And so together, let us join our forces to fight poverty and all the ills that are facing our two countries. Let us work together to for the welfare of the people of our two countries. And this is the message that I keep giving my counterpart in Pakistan. Along with President Trump, we also keep talking about the different bilateral issues between us.
Mr. Modi, would you like to have President Trump be involved in negotiating between Pakistan and India?
भारत और पाकिस्तान के सारे इश्यूज बायलेटरल है और इसलिए हम दुनिया के किसी भी देश को इनके लिए कष्ट नहीं देते हैं और मुझे विश्वास है कि भारत और पाकिस्तान जो 1947 के पहले एक ही थे हम मिलजुल करके हमारी समस्याओं पर चर्चा भी कर सकते हैं और समाधान भी कर सकते हैं.
India and Pakistan all the issues are of bilateral nature, and we do not want to give pains to any country in the world to try to do anything in this, because these issues are bilateral. And I trust that before 1947, when we were one country, that even afterwards we can find solutions through discussions.
Mr. President, is that office on the table?
I'm here. I have a very good relationship with both gentlemen, and I'm here if for any reason, but I think they can do it themselves. They've been doing it for a long time.
President, the Chinese have said today publicly that it's more low-level calls that have happened, and they're downplaying the significance of the calls the U.S. administration.
I don't know what you mean by that. Low-level? The vice premier is low-level? I don't think so. What's in your mind, they're low-level? What is the position of the gentleman that was quoted in the newspaper today?
Right. Well, the Vice Premier, Leo Ho, came out with a very significant statement, and we've been communicating through intermediary back and forth with him.
That's the Vice Premier of China.
Yes, sir, I understand.
That's not low level.
I understand, I agree. There was a statement that the spokesman for the Foreign Ministry said they weren't aware of the calls happening.
I don't know about as far as
there's been communication going on.
At the highest level. At the highest level.
Can you clarify the calls?
We don't want to go into it.
Hey, look, in the meantime, our country is doing great. We're doing great. Prime Minister just congratulated me. Everybody that's met has congratulated us on the job we're doing in the United States with our economy. Our economy is phenomenal. Best it's ever been. And that's despite the trade deals. And when the trade deals get done, like we did with Japan yesterday, we did a really big, tremendous trade deal with Japan. And we have others coming. We're negotiating now in earnest with the European Union because they want to do that. They want to do that, and I do too. So we have, when we get these deals done, our country will be transformed. I mean, it'll be monetarily transformed. It's such a difference between the horrible, horrible one-sided deals that we had in the past. And frankly, past administrations should be ashamed of themselves for allowing that. But we have many of them. One of them is the USMCA, Mexico-Canada. And hopefully that'll get voted on very quickly. Everybody wants it to happen, so hopefully we can make that a bipartisan bill. But we have many trade deals that are doing very well, and including China. And I think it was necessary to go through this, you would say a rough patch, but I'd say maybe much more than a rough patch. But that's okay, because we've been paid billions and billions of dollars. And you know that prices haven't gone up, and there's been no inflation, and we've put a lot of money in the Treasury, and tens of billions of dollars. And I've given a lot of it to the farmers that were hurt. I've been able to give a lot of money, compliments of China, to the farmers that were hurt, because we gave them $16 billion, and we gave them $12 billion the year before. That made them whole. That was the amount of money that China didn't invest in give to our farmers. So the farmers have been amazing, but they're very happy with the job we're doing. But eventually they're going to be the biggest, or one of the biggest beneficiaries.
Okay? Did you make it to the climate session? Were there any conclusions that you took?
I'm going to. In fact, it's going to be our next session. So we haven't had it.
Do you have a message that you'd like to deliver to?
No, I want clean air and clean water. And we're right now having the cleanest air and cleanest water on the planet. But that's what I want. I want absolutely clean air and clean water.
Do
Mr. President, just briefly back on China. We saw the comments from Liu about wanting calm.
Calm,
exactly. Just wondering if you can clarify what you meant about the call. Was that with light eyes?
I don't want to talk about calls. We've had calls. We've had calls at the highest levels. But
last night,
you
said last
that.
Night.
But the vice chairman put out a statement last night that was a statement and saying that he wants to make a deal and he wants calm. And I think it's a very good word to use, calm. Not a word that I use that often, but it's a good word to use. And I think it's one of the reasons that's a great country. I mean, they understand. I think that that message also helps with respect to Hong Kong. I really do. I think it makes it easier for Hong Kong to do something. And I think that President Xi will do something with Hong Kong. I really think that message is a good message with respect to what the ultimate outcome is in Hong Kong. Very, very positive message. And we appreciated it. We appreciated it. What else? Anything else?
Mr. President, what are your latest thoughts on your threat on pulling out of the WTO? And if you do, can I also ask Mr. President Modi what your response to that in terms of how it affect India's trade strategy?
Well, we haven't been happy with the WTO, but now we're winning cases. We won the big Airbus cases, you know. It's a tremendous case. I mean, it's billions of dollars. That was a very recent victory, and we're winning cases now. We're being treated more fairly now in the WTO, which we appreciate.
मुझे लगता है कि हम दोनों को बात करेंगे, हम दोनों बात करते रहेंगे, जब जरूरत पड़ेगी आप लोगों को जरूर जानकारी पहुंचाएंगे.
He actually speaks very good English. We just don't want to talk.
I think we should discuss these things and then we will communicate to you. Mr. President, Russia has just recently said they have no intention of being to be readmitted to the G7. However, no, I wouldn't expect they to ask because why would he's a proud man, he's done a real job, and why would he ask? No, it's something we discussed.
And it's under discussion now, no votes or anything, but I would be inclined to say yes, and so would others.